Bianca Belair and Shotzi as well. And here we go.
So for Charlotte Flair to get an opportunity at Io Sky for the Women's Championship, she's got to get through every member of Damage Control. Okay. That starts tonight against Asuka.
Same path that Bianca Belair must follow. She knocked off Kairi Sane last week. These two know each other so well, as evidenced there.
Cole, you've called so many matches at WrestleMania. The match between Charlotte Flair and Asuka at WrestleMania was regarded as one of the best female matches ever.
Well, Charlotte, of course, ending the undefeated streak of Asuka. These two have had quite the rivalry over the past couple of years. Two of the most decorated women in the history of WWE and Athletic as well.
Charlotte now. Kick out by Asuka.
John, what is it about Charlotte Flair that stands out, despite the fact she's a 14-time champion?
Well, the one thing you see, especially with her and Asuka, you know, is matchups make champions. You know, Ali was very fortunate to have Frazier. Charlotte Flair is very lucky to have Asuka because it shows the greatness of both in how they compete.
Well, Asuka moving out of harm's way, and Charlotte hit the post.
Oh, head first off the post. And Asuka rolling here.
Charlotte Flair is born with just incredible athleticism, but she also just happens to have the genetics to be a champion.
John, can you blame Asuka for wanting to join Damage Control and be part of this villainous faction?
Absolutely not. I don't know why you put some kind of hashtag on this faction. I mean, they've done a great job. They're the most dominant faction since the Crush Gals.
I agree, John. I think they're the most dominant faction in WWE's women's division today.
Charlotte just crushing the back of Asuka, and Charlotte now.
Uh-oh.
Heading toward the top rope. Flair with the moonsault. Oh!
Charlotte didn't get all of it, but she got enough.
Welcome back, folks. Providence, Rhode Island tonight. Tribute to the troops. Charlotte Flair and Asuka in action here.
Yeah, and that was nasty as we came back from commercial break. Asuka dropping Charlotte on the back of her head, and you can see Charlotte selling the effects of that move. John, that was a scary moment there.
Scary moment. A lot of times these ropes, they get wet as the time goes on from the sweat, from the different stuff that comes off competitors. And that's what happened with Asuka there. She slipped on there. Charlotte falls in an incredibly dangerous way.
And Asuka, though, is taking control of this matchup now, trying to take advantage of the situation.
And earlier on tonight, Asuka looking to bring out Damage Control with her, but Charlotte Flair had a plan, meaning this is 1v1. A story rivalry.
And again, you see the senior official, Charles Robinson, checking on Charlotte Flair. Make sure she is okay to continue this matchup after coming off the rope in a very dangerous way.
Charles Robinson, Navy for 6 years in submarines. An experienced WWE referee.
And Charlotte back to her feet now. Dragging Asuka center of the ring, perhaps looking for the figure eight here. Can she bridge?
Look at the bridge now, Flair. Can she do it?
Charlotte's getting it.
Oh,
Charlotte's got it.
Bailey, who was asked to stay back in the locker room area, getting involved. The official never saw it. Damage Control told Bailey to stay out of it.
Charlotte's rightly furious. Flair, just hammering Bailey. Asuka now. Can Asuka take it? She's got it.
Here's her winner, Asuka.
Well, that was a courageous performance by Charlotte Flair tonight. Asuka took advantage of the distraction by Bailey, did not backfire tonight.